Hello and welcome to Non-Stop Wrestling Chat. My name's Barry and this is your Fall Brawl 1995 watch along, turning it down so we can concentrate here, guys. I'm buzzing for this. Fall Brawl is one of my favourite. The War Games is one of my favourite matches. I love Fall Brawl because I had the two rings. Don't even get me started on the World War 3 with the three rings. So don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and that wee notification button if you like what you see, guys. Your support means a bunch to me. I really honestly don't know how to thank yous enough. When the minute we hit that 100 subscriber mark, I'm going to start getting giveaways as much as possible. When we're at the 1,000 subscriber mark and I can start monetizing the channel better, we're definitely going to be doing giveaways, like monthly things, probably monthly watch-alongs. We'll get people on and stuff like that as well. But so we're at 2 minutes 57. I'll just tell you 3 minutes. We're watching Flying Brian Pillman versus Johnny B. Badd, opening match of Fall Brawl 1995. So I'm probably going to cut this into two parts, just to kind of save on space-wise and stuff like that within the memory card, and also just so you're only sitting there watching a fucking 2 hour long, like, me talking like this. Also gives me a break to go to the toilet and stuff like that, which more than likely I'll do during this anyway. Been using this new razor, which has been really working really well. Cut nice here, all nice, soft. If he's ever become bald, he will understand the feeling of doing this. That's great. Trying to be about just frisbeeing things. Always loved Pilbara, definitely. When I'm older, I loved them more. When I was younger, I never really got them. Plus, I was fucking 6 or something when he was really doing his stuff. Like, at this age, fuck, I was only 4. Buffer. He's doing his wee announcements. I have always loved Fall Brawl. Well, when it had the War Games in it, there was a weird couple of ones that didn't have War Games, which was a waste of time. Excited to see this match. I have watched this one before. Just can't remember how it goes. Long day, guys. I'm recording this quite late at night as well, so we're going to do the watch along for bro. We're going to try and keep it mostly the matches, right? So anything that isn't match related, we'll probably just skip over. But hopefully, we can just kind of focus on those matches. Really excited for this one. It's got a big match vibe on it because I've been watching the Nitros with these guys, and it's just I've got the feel for it. Never a big B-Bad fan or Mark Merrow, never was a big fan. I just googled her, Pillman died in 97, that means I was 6, there's no way I remember him from when I was younger. Or barely remember him. Been watching a lot of the Jim Cornette stuff that's on YouTube just now. It's been pretty fun. He's like a man you can love to hate. Really slow start to the match. I'm looking forward to the 93 watch along. Watch the WrestleMania 9. The Raw 93 watch along, sorry, to watch WrestleMania 9. Pillman was always a guy I liked to watch when I was older. I really did like his stuff a lot. I know they brought back War Games, but I'm wondering if they would ever have WWE's like a franchise, so like they just go right, SmackDown, Raw is under the WWE umbrella, but we're gonna give WCW is going to be set back up, ECW, and Heyman can run ECW the way he wants to do it, or whoever the way he wants to do it. It's just they can do it, we'll help fund it, and as long as they make whatever, we'll just give them it. WCW, we get whoever, they can just make it the way they want it and just let it go. I think it's also giving people that opportunity, like even though WWE is like the umbrella company for it, but it gives like the opportunity for all these side little shows and stuff like that just to make wrestling big again, instead if you kind of like WWE's got Raw, SmackDown, NXT UK, just kind of try and make like the territories again, because they need to make their own talent, because there's barely any places to go just now. the fallout effects of this is a lot of good wrestlers that even I know that have had to go get jobs and stuff. They're making a living with it. They've not had anything kind of coming in this year, so they've had to go get a job. They can't afford to keep pushing the way you would think. So I think it's going to be a fallout effect from the COVID kind of lockdown stuff, which we're going to see, and it's probably going to be huge. Thing about this match, guys, you enjoying it? Because I'm actually really enjoying it just now. Worst thing, like I say, is watching these and I forget that I'm talking to you guys on the camera and I just end up sitting enjoying the match. I've been so busy this week, guys, I don't even remember what day it is. The other day I thought it was Sunday. Sorry, I sent her a couple of emails. So what we got? Do you know, I have a few of the old 1PW pay-per-views on DVD, and have a few independent shows that have like Raven and stuff on it. I think I might do a wee watch along with them, running up to the Christmas time, just to add in extra stuff and grab onto that independent shit. Obviously, WWE Network's got some ICW stuff, some WXW, Evolve, so I might even jump on that and watch a few of them, do watch along, so then you can jump on and watch it and we can chat like this. This has been a really good match so far. Just like a trying to be bad, it's got Brian Pillman in a submission move right now. He's letting it go because he got the ropes. the wee steps heading up to the heading up to the ring. Brian Pillman's looking for that handshake from B-Bird. Kicks. Pillman's just came in from out being outside the ring. Couple of moves and threw B-Bird out. Hard right hand, bite from Pillman, bite. Ref's telling Pillman, let that go, stop that, shite. Oh. Be bad, flipping leg drop, looked pretty cool. Just a two. He's got him in a chin lock just now. Match is getting a little bit slow again, isn't it? Like, close count here, 10, 8, Pillman's up. I don't know what much they say about this match, guys. Just really, it's good. Like, flip outside there look pretty bad. what's it called? It's been a pretty long match, isn't it? I think it's went a little bit too long, to be honest with you. Pile driver, tombstone, to kick out. Be bad going for the cover. Kick out by Pillman. An arm hold here. Russian leg into a submission by Pillman. Literally just been submission hold after submission hold here. Nearly 23 minutes into it. Definitely a little bit too long for this match. Doing the old arm. Is B-Bad going to pump it back up? Oh yes, he's coming back. One, two. Oh, B-Bad thought he got the win because Pillman had his feet in the ropes. Flying clothesline. One, two. No, it's just two. Roll up. The bell went. Time limit. Overtime. Sorry, the overtime really. Hmm. can't even remember who wins this, but I'm going to say it's going to be B-Bad. Pullman will do the job on the way out. That's what I would think. Flying Brian up high, double drop kick. See, Brian drop kicked and B-Bad drop kicked as well. So this match is really going on, isn't it? Looking at the timeline, it looks like we could have fucking almost another 8 minutes. Round about 7 minutes, 8 minutes. Right, nothing against these guys, who both of them are great workers in this match, right? But they've literally just done the same thing. They'll do like a couple of big moves, and then they'll just go to a submission hold and sit there. And then they'll do a couple of big moves, submission hold, sit there, submission hold, sit there. Out the ring, they're doing the same thing. Just doing the arm thing again. Is it two? B-Bad's probably going to come back right now, told you. Two of them in one match, isn't he? Isn't he good? Right now, B-Bad's got Pillman in a sleeper. Backdrop. Sorry for the yawning, guys. This has been a good match, but they are doing the same stuff. Now I think it's heading up to the end because I'm starting to like think out the box in it. Oof, that was a great move there. They jumped right over the top into the roll up by B-Bird. Close calls after close call. Hurricane ran off top rope by B-Bad. One. To another kick out by Pillman. What are we going to have to do to keep these men down? time. Brian with a DDT off the top rope. One, two, kick out. I honestly thought that was it. So this is actually turning into a really good match here. Pillman was going up. B-Bad hit the ropes, like fell into them. So Pillman got the... Don't know what's going to happen here. Oh, he's tossed them out. What the... Guardrail. B-Bad came jumping at the ring there and just looked bad when he hit him. B-Bad just jump over to Pillman's knees. One, two, kick out again. Okay, how are the guys who put these guys down? Pulling out the ring. Pillman went up the ropes, he'll jump off and got himself caught on the nutsacks. Close call again. Oof. There you go, B-Bad picked up the win. I knew that was going to happen. I honestly thought that was going to happen just because I'm sure Pillman leaves not long after this to go to the F or the E. So I'm going to skip over the Ric Flair talking about Arn Anderson. I'm going to head to Cobra versus Sergeant Greg Pittman at 41-16, 41-20. 41, 23, 24, 25. Had a quick toilet break. Cobra looks fucking massive. I don't know how much steroids that guy's on. Guess he's the face since he gave kids his necklace thing. buzzing for next week, guys, because on Tuesday I'm going to be wearing my Christmas jumpers and we're going to have this over in front of the Christmas tree. It's just over there now. I don't know what's going on here. Somebody coming down for the roof. No clue what's going on here. It's like they're trying to make it like an action movie or something. Commando crawling. Going on. What the hell is happening in this? Such 90s shit. Oh. I'm glad they never gave this Code Red and shit. They're tapped out. Thank God for that. That was fucking disastrous, wasn't it? Honestly, no clue what was happening here. So we're going to jump over a DDP versus Renegade for the World TV Championship. That's at 51-11, 51-12, 51-13, 51-15. DDP with a cigar, coming out with his wife. Like late here, Diamond Dallas Page is in like his 40s or something, isn't he? Getting out of hold the ropes and stuff is pretty a cool touch to like him being a heel. Oh, Renegade, I forgot about him. Pretty much just a different Ultimate Warrior, wasn't it? A shitter version of it. Paige looks weird, like, with what he's wearing. Because I'm used to seeing him, like, his jeans on and stuff like that. Like, he just looks weird. Paige just walked into the ring post by herself. It's weird seeing Paige like this because you're just used to seeing him with like he's later WCW ring, you know? Like this just looks like just looks really weird. I've never seen a lot of Renegade matches. I think I've maybe seen one. And I think it might actually be this match. It's a pretty good match, honestly. It's not the best, but it's pretty good. Yeah, it just doesn't look great. Normally you should have seen him in his other gear. Seen him like this. Fucking pretty. Pretty cool match for the times. Do you guys like DDP? He's a guy who's I've always kind of liked. I remember getting an action figure when I was younger, in fact, for Christmas. It was a. He had like his blue jeans and like a little leather waistcoat with a thing. I've always liked him, I've always been intrigued by his work, but like. It's no somebody I'd sit down and say he's in my top wrestler of all time, but he is. He's in my top 20, definitely. I'm really not like a huge early WCW lover. I would probably say I enjoy WCW better when it changed to the NWO stuff. And you know, I do like it. See, back at the late at the end, the pay per views end with stuff against like Scott Steiner and Booker T. You get a couple of good matches at the end there as well with some of the newer guys that came in. That's when I really remember WCW from. Looks like they might be getting this to Renegade, but I don't know. By the way, guys, just so you know, I'm expecting you to have this loaded up. The full brawl loaded up and watching it as well along with me, because I had somebody who watched the whole thing and says like, I didn't know what was happening. Obviously I'm expecting you to load it up as well. We're heading into the hour on this, so we're probably going to be ending part one here in the next 10 minutes or so, and then I'm going to be getting part two loaded up. We'll probably end part one just after this. After this match. And then we'll get part two started. I think Renegade's going to go for the win here. Oh, out to the big guy on the floor. Diamond cutter. 1, 2, 3. Diamond Dallas picked up the win. So when we come back, so we're going to end part one there, we're at the 50 minute mark, so when we come back we're going to be at 1 hour, 3 minutes and 44 seconds to watch Harlem Heat versus Buck and Slater, so that should be a good match. Then we've also got Arn Anderson versus Ric Flair, and then obviously the War Games. Right guys, so I'm going to love yous just now, the part 2 will be up in another. Should be up when you have watched this, and stay tuned, click part 2.